I know that our service is going to run long today. But we have to have a moment, right? I mean, we're coming to this moment, and we're coming to God in prayer. And surely, even if you've just returned from Mexico, you have seen the news. Some of you have more age than I, and some of you have less age than I. This is a bit of a scary time in our country. To see men, mostly men, all white men, walking through the campus of the University of Virginia, holding torches, shouting things that we thought maybe 40 or 50 years ago we could get beyond. Saying things about people of the Jewish faith and people of color. We need to name that what it is, my friends, and that is sin. Yes. I want to say something to you. I don't care who you voted for president. I don't care what political party you align yourself with. The events of the last weekend have got to be condemned by people who are people of faith. We call ourselves disciples of Christ for a reason. Jesus came so that Jews and Gentiles could know the love and grace of God. Jesus came so that men and women, sorry, Patty, can know the love of God. This is what we hear from Paul, right? And Paul, who was alive at the same time that Jesus was alive, this is the message. I believe everyone in this room has the privilege in this denomination of reading scripture and going from your own experiences and understanding faith from your reading of scripture and putting that all together. You, by virtue of being a part of the Christian Church Disciples of Christ, can determine for yourself. But I believe that the alt-right movement that claims one race is not of God. I believe that those of us who call ourselves faithful have to make that claim boldly. The time for passive faith is gone. That's what I believe. I encourage you in your coffee clutches, in your book studies, in your conversations with coworkers, in your neighborhoods, when you hear someone speaking something that is not of faith, that you will have the courage and the conviction of faith to speak words that need to be spoken. My prayer this day is that we can come into this place and know God in such a powerful way today that we will find that courage and that conviction. So as we pray for all the names that we have spoken, as we pray for all those that we've left unspoken, as we pray for our world even beyond Charlottesville, that is hurting and is in need. Let us pray for ourselves to find our God in this place this day. So let us take a moment of silence to breathe in that Spirit of God and let go of those cares and those anxieties that might keep us from being true followers. So let us pray, and let us begin our prayer in silence. O God, our God, our loving, compassionate, gracious God. We can't even imagine how your heart must break . You have created all that is, and you have claimed it to be good. And we struggle to find that goodness. We struggle to share your goodness. Be with us this day, God. And we mean that. Be with us this day, God. Show up. Awaken us in new ways to your presence as we gather for worship this morning. We seek to honor and bless you, but God, we need to know something today. We need to know. We need to know your love. We need to know how to share your love with others. We are struggling as individuals. We are struggling as families and friends. We are struggling, and as a nation, God, we are struggling. Be with us in our struggle. Deliver us, for deliverance comes from you. Deliver us, O God, to a time that is better than the events of the last few days. Deliver us into a world that says all are valued. Deliver us into a time where your ways are known and lived out. Deliver us as your people to be people of courage and conviction. You grace us in so many ways, and we know that even in the midst of this mess, that you will forgive and that you will bring something good. For wherever there is goodness, there is you, God, and you are our good God, and you alone are our good hope. Take us from our despair to a new place of faith and hope. This we pray this day, God, as disciples of Christ. This we pray, God, using words that your Son taught his disciples so long ago and has even taught to us. Hear us as we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.